Hello dear students, welcome to our class 12th English, and there are three sections. Section A, that is for comprehension, right? Means unseen comprehension is there in that. Section B is your advanced writing skills. Section B, in this short and long compositions will be there, right? And section C is for exclusively specified for literature, in which two books are there, you know, Flamingo and Vistas. But right now this is not our subject matter. We have to deal with this one, section B, and the short composition. The first topic of short composition today is advertisement. What is advertisement? I think I should not explain the term advertisement, because almost everybody in modern world, in the recent time, everybody is very much familiar, very much acquainted with the term advertisement, right? We'll learn them later, one by one. But before I proceed, let me tell you what is an advertisement. If scientifically, if we go for advertisement, means a means of communication to give public information to one and all, right? Means of communication in written format, in verbal and non-verbal advertisements, means commercial on TV, while watching a program, while watching a movie. That time also you might have come across so many advertisements known as commercials. In newspapers, so many advertisements are there. So I mean to say, advertisements are meant for informing people, conveying a particular specified information to mass number of people, to the mass, to a great number of people, right? One more purpose is there. Advertisement means I want to boost up the sale, means I want to promote one of the goods I have to sell, means I want to give the customers, to the readers, and to large number of people about the product I am going to launch. And maybe suppose I am going to organize an event, for that purpose also I will have to go for advertisement. Right now we are not talking about the kinds of advertisements, but I am just talking about the term advertisements, right? Vigyapan, in Hindi it's known as vigyapan, right? So look, they are basically, broadly, we have classified the term advertisement into three categories. Means three categories are there. First is classified advertisement. First one is classified advertisement, okay. Second one is display advertisement, commercials, display advertisements. Third one is display classified. Display classified means, third one is display classified, means combination of first two, right? Means we have taken some features from display and some features from classified, we have made them together, and another advertisement format is there under the name display classified. This is for your practical knowledge only. Otherwise we have got nothing to do with this one and this one, because we have to go for a examination curriculum, right? So only this one we have to read, we have to learn what classified advertisements are there, right? Look, suppose this is a newspaper, right? One of the pages of your newspaper, and over there it will be written classified. You might have seen a specific page is there, a specific page number is there on which these advertisements are inserted, and they are known as Vargikrit. In Hindi newspapers, they are known as Vargikrit Vigyapan, otherwise we know them by classified advertisements in English newspapers. But in most of the Hindi newspapers also, we may find English advertisements classified, right? So you can see in this way, columns are there in the newspaper, different columns are there, right? So in this way, this is you might have seen so many advertisements under different categories, right? So this is known as classified. Let's broadly learn it, what classifieds are. Classifieds means, I told you, they are meant to be inserted, published on a specific page. Fixed page is there. We cannot insert these ads, these advertisements on any page number of our own, page number of our choice. Sometimes it happens that we want to give our advertisement, we want to give our advertisement on page number one. Maybe last page number, because most of the readers have very easy look, easy attention, we can draw theirs, right? So, in the case of classified advertisements, no separate page number of our own we can go for. We have to confine ourselves to a specific page number on which classified cluster, groups of, means so many classified advertisements are there, means all classified advertisements for that day edition, they will be published here only on this page number. Got it? So, specific page number, nowhere else we can give them, nowhere else, right? Next is cheapest mode, means they are cheapest. We have to incur, we have to spend only a little, because what is our main mode? What is our main objective? Our main objective is to inform people, and for merely informing people, why to spend so much money? That's why they are cheaper, right? Cheapest mode of advertisements. That only text is allowed, means I'll give you example also, but right now only text, means written words are allowed, nothing else is there. No design, no logo, no company monogram, no colors, no premium type of advertisements, no particular designs are at all allowed, no different fonts are allowed, only and only simply type text is there, right? And one more thing about this, it has got word limit also, means the charges are levied, the charges are imposed according to the number of words we are using and column, right? So common word limit is 35 words. So you might have been confused, so within 35 words, how is it possible? This is, that's why we can call them cheapest mode of advertisement. We have to communicate only. A common information is to be informed to people, to all people, or to a particular class of people. That's why they are cheapest and fixed number of words are there. But suppose we want to add some more words, obviously we will have to spend extra money, we will have to give extra charges, right? So these are some salient features of classified advertisements. Now have a look at their categories. Categories these are. So what I told you, look, this, in this way, these are the names of columns. These are the names of columns, under them different advertisements according to their purposes, according to their objectives will be inserted, right? So first is, these are some prominent advertisements, classified advertisement categories. What is their purposes? Lost and found, we already discussed. I lost something, or I found something at a public place, and I am going to give the advertisement for the same purpose, that is lost and found, missing. Most of the students get confused regarding lost and found and missing. This is, so why to use them separately? They both are same, meaning is same, lost and found or missing. No, not at all. There is big difference between the two. What? Lost and found is used for non-human being, non-living being, right? And missing is used for human beings. Yes, suppose one of our relatives, maybe our siblings, one of our siblings has gone away somewhere and he or she has not come back, then so this ad is known as missing. Under the column missing, it will be inserted. But if you have lost something, I'm not saying someone, somebody, if you have lost something or if you have found something, this is lost and found, right? Next is available, means I got something to dispose, to provide, to make it available. For example, available services, I can give my ad. Available finance, available consultancy, available land means two-let services, you might have heard two-let, right? So available land, available property. So in this way, this is available services. Matrimonials, very interesting. Matrimonials means related to marriage, right? I am looking for a bride for my son. I am looking for a groom for my daughter. So I will go for this kind of advertisements, right? Matrimonials means wanted bride, wanted groom means bridegroom, but generally it is used as groom. Okay, you might have seen so many. Next is required or wanted. This school is there. The vacancy or position of some teachers. So, required or wanted English teacher, wanted maths teacher, or wanted clerical staff, computer staff, tutors, faculties, right? So, required or wanted means position, right? Next is sale and purchase, means I have got something to sell, means my plot, means land, my house, villa, Bangalore, my vehicle, means two wheeler, four wheeler, or any vehicle. So I have to sell for that purpose, or I have some household goods that I have to sell. That's it. Or maybe I want to purchase a second hand, something second hand means used. So for that purpose also I can go for this one, right? And last not the least is, I know so many categories are there, but these are some prominent categories. Name chain. Suppose I am 12 years old and I have to change my name. So very easily, but one of the formalities right now also, suppose I want to change my name, then I'll have to undergo some legal formalities, and one of the formalities is I have to give this advertisement in the newspaper just as a common information to be communicated. Means I want to inform a large number of people that I am going to change my name from this to this, so that in future people must know me by my new name, and any formality, any dealings under my previous name will prove null and void, right? They will be of no use. And if any people is found making any kind of deal or transaction under my previous name, will fall null and void, means I won't be liable responsible for them, right? So this is legal formality, name change. This advertisement is given. I hope you have got it. So now I'm going to give you one example, right? Because example is better than precept. So I'm going to draw one of the classified advertisements, right? And in this way it will be easier for you to get how to. And one more thing about this kind of advertisement, what generally we have to prepare them in the form of phrases. What? In the form of phrases only. Such kind of advertisements are generally prepared in single sentence, and that single sentence has got so many phrases according to the purpose. Have a look. First of all, in your examination, first of all you are supposed to make a box, and that should be rectangular box, right? Look. In this way, but not manually, you have to use a ruler, scale, right? The better you are giving, the better you will be gaining. So if you are giving to the examiner best stuff from your side, so you will be expecting best marks from your examiner, right? So this box is there, but you don't have to draw the bottom line. That will draw at the end when we are finished, because sometimes it so happens that because of our handwriting, because of the size, we happen to cross this limit and then we feel inconvenience and it looks occurred. Got it? So first of all, from three sides, vertical, rectangular box is to be prepared. Okay, and then we have to this first. This is a box, but in practical life you don't have to prepare, but in exam you have to prepare this box. What I told you, different categories are there, names of columns, so we may call it the name of column under which this advertisement is going to be inserted, right? So suppose I am going for sale and purchase and this one means I am going to sell my car. Okay, so what kind of advertisement should be there? Suppose you get this question in your exam. You are going abroad and you have to dispose your car. So you have to give this kind of advertisement in the newspaper. Have a look. So this box we have prepared, but first of all we have to prepare this category. Car for sale, and in exam you have to highlight it, car for sale. This is the name of the category, name of the column, and in this column we have to write. So car for sale, this is, and maximum word limit is 50 words. Kindly do not try to exceed that. So the examiner doesn't want to know what you are writing. The examiner wants to know how you are writing. So this is very important. What we are doing is not as important as how you are doing, because you know, you all are sensible people, 12th class senior students. So what you are writing, you know it very well. So the examiner is least interested in knowing that. Got it? So the examiner wants to know how you are doing. Okay? So I'm going to prepare this ad for the sale of my car. Look, a Maruti Wagoner in bracket 2014 October. This is, you know, making and model, right? Name of the model and name of the company. A Maruti Wagoner 2014 October is available for early sale. This, then excellent in running condition, single-handed new tires, good audio video, insured, right, at 'reasonable price'. Got it? You can see single sentence is going on, huh? This much, then contact, you have to give a contact number, not address, because word limit is there, means only 35 words. As far as possible you have to finish this ad in your practical life, I'm talking about 35 words, and in your exam 50 words. So why to give address? It may consume so many precious word limit, right? So reasonable price, contact, and you have to give your contact number. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, in this way. This is contact number, right? But sometimes it happens, as soon as we give this advertisement in the newspaper, we start being disturbed. We start getting disturbed by so many brokers and agents, and we do not want this kind of tension, disturbance. So just make a note of it. Brokers, kindly excuse. Got it? So you can see only 50 words limit is there. Let's count. Roughly we are going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. So what I told you, maximum word limit is 50 words. So in this way you can prepare this kind of advertisements, and it will be complete. And if you really follow this pattern, no doubt you will be obtaining 4 on 4, means short composition carries 4 marks in your exam. 2 will be there, out of 2 you will have to go for, you will have to opt for 1. So hope you have got it. See you next time. Till then, have a nice time. Stay blessed. Stay home. Thank you.